Welcome to Derek's Piano Tutorial number 22, part 2. In part 1, I did a diagram of the staff of FC1, FC2, and FC3. And they're all organized in intervals, which is the second interval going up or down between treble bass, middle C, and bass D. In this video, it's going to be the same thing. It's the same FC1, FC2 and FC3, which corresponds to flashcards 10, 11, and 12. But this time I'm gonna draw a pictorial diagram of the piano layout so you'll know what an interval is in relationship to the staff. The staff have holders, which is a line and a space. And the distance between a line and space is a second. So I'm gonna illustrate what a second is as to go through the keys of the piano for FC1, FC2, and FC3. In order to understand what I'm talking about, you do have to download the flashcard. They always have the download link at the end of each piano tutorial. Sometimes the video could be 10 minutes long, and so I leave out the download link like that, and I just didn't have time to add the download link to all the descriptions at a time. With that, I will continue with the pictorial diagram of the layout of the piano. Let's start with the flashcards in questions. The first one, FC1, we have a group of three for the upper hand. Upper hand is my right hand, right here. I usually call upper right because that's the direction of piano. If you go up on the staff, then you're going up the keys on the right, which is a higher tone. And the bass is the lower tone. You go on the left right here. So you start with finger two. There's a number two right here. Finger two right here. And so that means you start with finger two and you play a second above middle C, which is a D. Usually, if you're a new piano student, the teacher will ask you to memorize it using acronyms like F-A-C-E. You encourage to do that because that's the standard traditional way of memorizing it. Here is where you can use a reference point. So the ruler will be the ledger lines, which is the horizontal lines. There's no implied middle C because the slash is missing. So it starts with D and go up a second because it goes a space and a line. I explained that in a previous video. So instead of explaining the staff, I'll explain the piano layout. And so I'm gonna draw it right here. Part three, I will do a run through. Basically, I have a real piano in front of me. I'll record how I play dun dun dun, and I have metronome, and that's called a run through. But here is, I'll just draw you the layout of the piano because I want to illustrate the distance between the white keys, if two keys touch each other, it's a second. If you have a note on the same line, you're playing it first. So you press the key and you let go like that. So a second. And also the type of note denotes the duration. So as a quarter note, as a dark circle with a stem, as a quarter note, you hold it for one count. So you count four beats to a measure. Most of the beginning flashcards are four beats to a measure. And so you hold it for one count. And then you have another note you're playing first, you let go and you count. So now you have a half note, which is a white circle with a stem, that a hollow circle with a stem. That's two beats. So you hold it for one, two. So let's say you have a quarter note, and a half note. You hold it for one, two, three, four. You hold a total of four counts. Now I'm gonna draw you the piano layout. In the piano layout, we have white keys surrounded by black keys. If the white keys surrounded by two black keys, the three white keys is C, D, E. If you have a white key surrounding three black keys, the letter names is F, G, A, B, right here. And so the reference point would be middle C. And usually when you play a grand piano, the Yamaha is a little bit about an inch to the left of the logo, Yamaha. That's the middle C. And usually when you start and play, you look at a Yamaha. And so that's where the middle C is located. And then I'm going to draw you four middle C, then you have four white keys on the right side. And the last one on the right side will be treble B. I put a little arrow in it. TB is middle C. And then I'll put a little arrow for MC for middle C. And then bass D right here. Bass D. So there you go. Middle C right here, treble B, and bass D. And a bass D. And then so the first flashcard, you're playing a second above middle C, which is a D, and you go up a second and you go down a second. And then and then you play with your lower hand, which is a second below middle C, and you which is a B actually, and you play it, and you go down a second and you go back up a second, and you count properly. So you play middle two, and C. You go up a second right here. C, and you go up second, and then you go back. D, go up second, you go down second, and then B right here. You play right here, you go down second, and you go down, and you hold it for 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, that's the first flashcard. We are now proceed to FC2, the second flashcard. And same thing is you have treble B right here, and you play with finger two, because this is number two right here. You go up a second, and then you go down a second. And then bass D right here, you go down, you play bass D, you go down a second, and you go up a second. Finally, on the FC3, you have middle C right here. You go up a second, and you go down a second. And then lower hand, you play middle C, you go down a second, and you go up a second. So there you go, FC1, FC2, and FC3. And then I'll do a run through the next part three. Okay, thank you. Hi, welcome to Derek's Piano Tutorial. If you like the flashcards, you can download at the iCloud link at the link below.